Okay guys, today I'm making an unboxing video for the Acer V3 771G 9809. So this is how it comes from Acer. This is the outer box here. By the way, I recommend you don't use paring knife, but I didn't feel like grabbing a box cutter from outside. Alright. Outer box open. Some packing peanuts. Pretty standard stuff. Here is the inner box. Inner box. Peanuts are staticky. Trying to avoid having to vacuum the whole house after doing this. Get these in here. So this was ordered from Acer.com on their crazy sale that they had for $7.99. Selling for $900 on Acer, or $950 on Acer, $900 on Amazon. So, that's how it comes. Got a nice packing slip here. And I'm gonna put this aside right now. Let's see what's going on in here. I'm a little excited if you can't tell. Alright. Because this is my old computer. Had it for 5-6 years. Integrated graphics card. TV5500 dual core CPU. It's been great. It's an Acer, and that's why. Got another Acer. Never had any problems with it. So this is the box, everything in it. Got a little quick start guide here. It's kind of backwards. It's kind of weird. I'm a little weary about Windows 8. I've used it a few times. And I'm not too fond of it so far. So, alright, we've got power cable here, or part of one. Minus the part that plugs into the AC. Here's that piece. This is in a Ziploc bag. Here is the battery. Gonna need that. Alright. I was tracking this thing online, like, probably refreshing the tracking on my phone and my laptop about 100 times a day. No joke. So excited about this. Here's the battery. Kind of a weird shape. It's actually really kind of light, kind of lightweight. It looks like there's, actually I can't even tell how many cells are in here. I'm gonna guess like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 maybe. Maybe it's a 9 cell, maybe it's 6 cell. Doesn't say on here right off the bat, can't tell. So, let's get on with it. Power cord. Gonna need this. I prefer when I get new electronics to plug it in for the first use and charge up the battery and kind of discharge it all the way about 3-4 times. It's my personal preference. And it's always worked for me. All my batteries last a couple years, usually. This Acer battery for this laptop lasted about 4 years, pretty decent. And then, well, probably 3 years, decently. And then it went way downhill where it would last about 1 minute tops. So, get this plugged in. This is a little big. Kind of a generic brand. Chicconi, Jabroni. Is that Tony Danza used to say that? It's kind of big. I guess they're putting more electronics in the wall adapter now to keep the transformer needs on the laptop down. All right. Got that all plugged in. Let's take out the laptop here. There's another handy little guide in here. No software. Some little, it looks like business cards with Windows shortcuts. I guess people are going nuts with Windows 8. Like, losing their shit about it. Which, who knows, I may do. Another box down. Another cardboard down. Yep. I just felt a really strong static shock on my hand from taking that cardboard off. This thing, whatever this is completely charged up with static. That's a bad idea on Acer's behalf, whatever this material is. I'm actually going to look. It's polyethylene, PET, I think that's polyethylene, 01 recyclable, so bad idea Acer, a lot of static in that. Battery in, I'm a little paranoid now that static could have zapped my computer. Here's the laptop with the bottom. This is the expansion. Acer's pretty good about their expansion ports, getting to the important components, but we'll see on this laptop whether the CPU is accessible from underneath or not. I don't think it is because this is the fan. Pretty beefy fan. Pretty good. Looks like pretty good design there. So the CPU is probably around here. Possibly over here. To my knowledge, though, this is probably the other hard drive bay, and there's 4 RAM slots in here, so that'll be for another video, though. And just because of that static shock, I'm gonna plug this in to the laptop first, like so, and make the final connection here. It's the same as making it at the wall, making the connection here. It's the same as the 3-prong plug you put into the wall, just to avoid any electric craziness going on there. Alright, open it up. Let's turn it a little bit here. Looks so far so good. Nice little sticker here. I don't know what the point of that is. Keyboard protector locks pretty well. Little addendum. Must read. Your notebook tablet is plugged in an AC power supply to activate the battery before you turn it on the first time. The first time startup and setup for your operating system may take up to 30 minutes. Well, there you go. That's another reason to plug it into wall power. You don't want it shutting off. Nope. I guess this is my SD slot here. I guess. That thing's huge. I guess it takes compact flash too, probably. Alright. So, first boot up. Make sure everything looks good before. Keyboard looks good, feels good. It's got good feedback. Let's turn it on. See if it works. So I am filming this, by the way, from my guitar stand. I'll show you that at the end of the video. And I am going to close my blinds here to show the screen better without glare, and go ahead and turn off this light. See if we can see it a little better. Turn this all the way here. Let's see. Not too great. I'm going to tilt it back a little bit at the ceiling. Alright, that looks good. Screen looks good. It's got a little bit of a kind of a diagonal waviness to it that my other Acer has as well. Battery on my phone's going dead already for some reason. It's a very glossy screen. Looks like there's no type of anti-glare on it whatsoever. So the startup screen just says Acer, explore beyond limits, whatever that means. So I'm really excited about this computer. It has the i7 3632QM, 2GB DDR2 RAM with the NVIDIA GeForce 650M, GT650M. The only two weak points of it are the finish, which I may kind of spiff up myself with some matte paint or something. We'll see. I don't really care that much about fingerprints. The other laptop I use besides the Acer has a piano black glossy finish, and I don't care that much, honestly. And then the other thing is the DDR3 instead of DDR5 on the graphics memory. But that can't be changed, obviously, because that's on the motherboard, soldered on, surface mount. So, only thing I'm likely to do with this computer is put in an SSD just for the operating system and programs, and I'll probably up the RAM to 16GB at some point. It's going to be used for SolidWorks, no gaming probably, but probably a lot of SolidWorks, CAD, running my online business and that type of stuff. So, alright, well, I'm going to get on with the setup, and I hope you enjoyed the unboxing video. Have a good day.